So, I want to start this video by how I actually discovered InstantOS, because it includes lots of drama, which is the main concept of this channel. First we have this video by DistroTube that was reviewing InstantOS. Then we have a video from InstantOS developer responding back to Derek. This video was very good really, and it was the reason that made me to try InstantOS at first place. And finally we have Derek's response to response video, that he finally discovered his true nature and that he is an idiot. And actually that was the first video I watched on these series, so basically I watched backwards. And anyway, point is that I tried InstantOS to see the actual desktop environment, but instead I fell in love with the installer that I hadn't seen before. And so I want to share this because it's impossibly sweet. I'm gonna use VirtualBox and not QEMU, because that's recommended by the developer for better UI performance, especially when you have NVIDIA. So, we select Linux, and then we select Arch, which is a huge bonus for InstantOS. Just setting memory to 4 GB. And next. Create a virtual disk now. VDI image, yes. Dynamically allocated so we can easily resize. And 8 GB should be enough. Besides, that's my second installation that I'm going to remove anyway. The image is already selected from previously, and by the way that's beta 3 release. So all done and let's start. Ah, the cute Arch Linux boot screen in chibi mode. But that's the only Arch Linux thing you're gonna see, because everything else is pretty much automated with just a few dialogues. Which reminds me to complain to Arch Project and ask them why the hell they don't offer a faster installer. It's not 2000 anymore, and Linux has become so much more complicated that the Arch installer is completely pointless to actually give configuration power to users. Custom and advanced configuration can take place post-install. Okay, so we have the first screen of InstantOS that detected the virtual machine and asks us if we want to set 1080 resolution. That was super nice, so yes here, and then I'm gonna full screen this. That's a welcome menu that we don't need, so quit. And from the top right we have the menu to start our installation. And now check out how cool this installation process is. Basically maybe this installer is used in more systems, but personally it is the first time I see it. So preparing installation, and OK here. On the bottom we get some messages for what's happening in the background, but later you'll see how much better that will get. So welcome back to you. And next we have the keyboard layout. US it is. Select language English, that I barely speak but anyway. Next selecting a mirror from Greece, and yes we have even filtering. On choosing mirror settings we want to sort by ranking score, that hopefully will find the fastest mirror near us. Then it asks us again if that is a virtual machine, and then it will ask us to choose the hypervisor which is VirtualBox in this case. And our demographics, region Europe, and city Athens. But I'm moving soon, probably next week. Next we choose our disk, and I guess if I had selected the experimental option it would add something like a custom partitioning. But I forgot to test, sorry. Next we just get a warning that will erase everything, so okay. Then it is our username, typically me, and next is our password and more typically my 4 digits, and a password confirmation. Next is the machine name, and God please, send me a slave angel to make the Linux installations for me. Here I am. Will you send me an angel? Do I ask a lot from this life? Anyway, next it's asking us to edit some advanced settings, but only if we know what we're doing. I have absolutely no idea, so I will press yes. Here we have the auto login, Plymouth and kernel options. And if we go on kernel we can choose between current and LTS, something that is kind of the new trend on Linux distributions. Next is a summary page that displays all our previous selections so we can double check. Meanwhile, aside keyboard navigation we can also use the mouse. I'm so totally in love with this installer. Next basically says that installation is about to begin and may take a while. But in the meantime look this awesomeness I told you before. On the bottom we get the installation progress messages. But if we switch on second workspace we can actually see the full installation logs. So basically we have the discrete mode here, or the full installation mode here. And of course this is a live installer, so while we're waiting for the installation to complete we can do stuff. Watch and learn Arch Linux, watch and learn. I'm not gonna show the Instant OS before the installation is completed because I want to have all the updates before. But you can see already there is some GNOME Shell essence on this menu, and the similarities with GNOME don't stop here. So, back to installation and waiting, and as you can see from the clock on top right it took less than 10 minutes to complete. Oh, which reminds me, Instant OS requires an internet connection for the installation. And after my godlike video editing skills, we are just a few seconds before everything ends. And everything ends kinda rough, because the system will restart without some messaging or something. So trust me, you don't want to watch Pornhub during. Hey what? It's a documentary?
Lisa?
Okay, and after education let's go back to entertainment and back to Arch boot screen, but this time we'll boot from the hard disk. And meanwhile I also like Instant OS logo, there is something filthy on it. So, next we'll again detect the virtual machine and ask us to change to 1080 resolution, and I wish every Linux was doing that. Meanwhile before we didn't get any reboot message, but now we get one that installation is finished. Oh, and another thing is that it didn't ask for our credentials. Probably we could set up that on advanced options that I skipped, but default behavior was auto-login, and in general Instant OS is a system targeting simplicity and easy of use, even it is a tiling window manager desktop. Anyway, first screen is the welcome screen, and in the meantime Instant OS thought to change the wallpaper for none reason at all. But whatever, and I will continue with the install option, that is basically the PAMAC app, one of the best software managers in Linux. Actually the very best! Minimize that, or whatever that's called on a TWM, by clicking on top bar, and clicking on background it will open the application launcher. First I will open customize look and feel, and set Arc Dark instead. That I personally consider it a very overrated theme. When we have some window on desktop, we can click on top right to open the application launcher. And next I'm going to open the settings. Wait a bit, I'm going to freeze the screen. You see, the settings menu is pop up here and I missed it on live action because I was expecting it as first result, and I only saw it later on video editing. And I'm gonna be straight honest here. So, speaking as a Linux user I got sick watching Linux developers trying and trying and trying to create the new and awesome distro and desktop, and failing and failing and failing. And moreover I'm failing to realize how these people believe they can create a full desktop with a team of less than 5 people, when projects like GNOME have literally hundreds of contributors and still can't do much. There is a serious problem in Linux desktop ecosystem, with people being unable to work together. And they unable to work together because everyone thinks is better than anyone else. Well, I got some flash news for all these people. You're not good developers. And you're not good developers because you don't create projects with actual value, but yet another suckful tiling window manager on the who really cares pile. Have all those said, I also have to admit that Instant OS is possibly the best suckless system I've ever seen, although my experience is very limited. Then again, if you want some tiling manager you can get PopShell, that possibly the compositor will perform better, so the performance metrics can be a bitch on such systems. Back again to the actual demo. And my next move was to search for Control Center. And I seriously loved we get some GUI for configuring at least some basic tasks of the system. Not very common in such environments. Oh, and when I said before that this thing has more similarities with GNOME, check out this motherfucking padding. Which is yet another evidence of the low development quality. To be fair Instant OS is kinda a new project so I can't really complain. But we all know these things are actual harder to fix than the actual window manager, so it is not I expect major visual improvements anytime soon. The most common issue with such desktops, is that we log in and we have absolutely no idea how they work. Luckily for us, Instant OS has addressed this with a very simple way. So if we open the menu in top left, there is a key bindings option, that will display all the shortcuts. Now if we could edit those directly from this window, everything would be better. Usually I'm against rebinding shortcuts, but that's a common scenario on tiling window managers. Another neat thing I want to show is the terminal emulator. It uses a simple terminal from Suckless, but this is coming with TMUX pre-configured. So after that info message, that we say don't show again without even reading it, we can right click and bring this menu. And finally someone realized that TMUX should come pre-configured like that. This is a blast for new users. And from the blast back to curse, because when I opened the shutdown menu and tried to lock it, the blue screen of death came. That occasionally gets red. Then again that might been a sign sent from God, telling me I should stop this review now. Which is really a good sign, because it is better to use the desktop for 3-4 days, perhaps waiting for its stable release first, and then review the inside stuff. Besides, I already exceeded the 10 minutes video duration for Supreme YouTube ads. Oh, and also, if you use VirtualBox, don't forget to enable 3D acceleration and set some more CPU cores for the box, that I obviously forgot. So that was all for now, and so goodbye.